Okay, guys, so right now we will create the BNV to our new arena. The BNV is another model that you need to create so the characters in Oni can move in the arena that we had created. Okay, so how we do a BNV for Oni? I usually start by copy paste the model of the arena that I have just made. Then he opened another project. I have already another SketchUp project with the BNVs, and within this project we'll just do edit paste in place. As you can see, it pasted the arena that we have created exactly on the same position that it is on our SketchUp project model of the arena, so it is exactly in the same coordinates. When doing BNV, you don't use any texture, so let's just empty the textures. Also, I will give an example. This is the BNV of the lava arena. As you can see, basically I have copied the floor of the spectators and the floor where the fighters fight, and I have added these polygons over it. So what this means is that a character can be on this cell, and if it finds another vertical polygon just right to it says to the engine that it can transverse or pass this area. So it means that the character can pass this to this one. And then in this one it can pass to this one, to this one, and to this one cell. So basically what these vertical polygons say, they say that the character can pass between these the cells right here. You need to do the same for the cave arena, so we'll just do that. Let's start by creating a new layer on SketchUp for the BNV of the cave arena BNV. Let me just finish clearing the textures. Okay, now let's create a new layer. The layer on SketchUp means that you can show just a model or some models on a layer. So I have created already some layers, and you can see if I uncheck the visibility, it can just hide the models on the specific layer. So let's create a new layer for the cave arena. Cave. And let's check it as default, as the current layer. Okay, I have already created a cave arena layer. Let's just rename this to Arena 3 cave. Okay, so now we can just hide the other layers so we can focus on Arcade BMV. Okay, you need to clear all this model and just have the floor because BMV only works with the floor of the model. So let's clear this. Maybe there is an easier way to do this, but I don't know, so I will just do it like this. Okay, so let's fix the plane. The floor of the plane, like this, on the head axis. Sending like this on the head axis. Let's fix this. Okay, this side is not equal, so let's make sure it's equal. We'll do it like this. Okay, select this one and this one. Let's just check on the original model if the measures are the same. Okay, let's set the unities of our BMV project to centimeters. So it is the same as the arena model. Okay, so it says 374. And the 74. Okay, looks the same measure. Just check. Okay. Okay. So I have checked the measures, it's all okay now. We have our base for the BNV. This part right here will be the spectators area. You need to add a BNV for this area and another BNV for this one. Maybe you can add another layer like you have done for the other arenas, one for the spectator and another for the another for the fighters. So let's do just that. Then want this to be the spectator. So let's set it right here. And this one, it's cave. Okay. Yeah. Now it's working. So let's show the metric cave. Let's add spectator by now. This I want this to also be part of the spectator, so let's change it. Okay. Okay, let's try do the spectators area. So the same for the other ones. Okay, so I have just found an easier way to do the vertical planes. We'll do use the same push button, but we'll before clicking on the face, we'll click on control. It will change to a star. You can see the cursor, and then we'll just set it to on face. This way, it will also create the inside, so you don't need to fill it later manually like this first one. Okay, so let's do the same for the remaining cells. Okay, it's finished. So let's delete the above polygon. So now the thing is, the spectators can transverse this part because it's outside of arena, and can't go to the other side because it's where the fighters are. So we'll just delete the vertical planes on right and on the left. So let's just do that. Okay, so as you can see, it's now finished. Only the vertical planes where the spectators can transverse are visible, are draw. Just make sure that Tony identifies these closer planes as two and not just one. So let's draw a line over here. Okay. Same thing here. Need to unselect this option and this one. You don't select any option. Okay, so let's export it. Let's try in the game to see if the characters and the spectators can already move on the arena. Now I have just remembered that for the spectators to work, you need to tell them which pad they should use to move on an arena. So you need to change this VLCL file and tell them the paths that you just created like before this one, IT2, so they can run over the arena. So let's do this for all these conditions. Okay, so I have finished adding all these conditions for the cave arena. So the spectators move using the pads that we made. Let's try in the game to see if it's working correctly. And as you can see, the spectators are already moving on this arena. The spectators can now move over the arena. I'll finish going down. That hurt. Okay, I did the spectators area and I will now create the BNV to the main arena. So let's start that. So I think you can begin creating the polygons for the more complicated areas like these openings right tier where the player will pass. So script on like this. Script the rectangle. Okay, you have the rectangle, so this will just tell the character that they can pass this area. Let's copy this to the other side. Okay, let's move this to the other side. Just click on Control and move like this. Okay, now we can start by deleting the walls. Since in BNV they don't have any use, any other use than just being used as a guideline. So let's delete it. You already don't need them anymore. Let's use the same technique, select one, then click on one point of the polygon, click Control, then just move to create a bunch of vertical planes. Okay, this short. Be okay. Maintain this rectangle right here, so it serves as a guideline. Okay, so this one is done. You also need to do this one, and this one, plus these ones right here. But right now I will just copy this part that you have done to the other side to simplify the editing for us. Okay, just like that. You can use the same thing. Can use the same technique also for this one. Passage and the other one. So let's do that. Okay. This part right here is done. Let's just left the these polygons right here. So I will just delete the other ones like I have done before. Okay, I have edited all the same passages, so they are exactly the same, the BNVs. Okay, so now we need to work on the others. That are this one, this one, this one, this one, this one, this one, and finally this one. So let's start with this one right here, for example. I went same weight like this here. So let's see. Something like this. Yep, something like this. So the character will only try to move in this area, don't get blocked in this. Okay, let's delete the rem let's copy. This polygon right here to the other side. We will use same technique that he have been using. Okay. Let's just delete now the wall. Okay, I will create another one between these two. Okay. It's good. You can use the same technique, the same planes to this passage right here, so let's do that also. Okay, that part is done. Let's do the remaining three passages. And this same weight. Now let's clear the wall in the middle. Okay, now let's just create another polygon in the middle of this tree. Okay. Okay, so the passage BN viz is done, but now you need to do also the vertical planes for the remaining arena fields. So this area like here, this area like here, this area in here. This area in here, this area in here. So let's do that. Also, I will delete these vertical planes right here because they don't make any sense. Because characters can't pass to the spectators area, so I will delete these. So I will start by doing that. Okay, so the spectators wall is deleted because it doesn't make sense for us in the BNV. Let's now fill the remaining area, this area right here, with the remaining vertical walls. I will copy some guidelines from the main model, so it will be easier for us to see where we effectively need to place the vertical planes. Copy. Edit it, paste in place. Okay, so now you have guidelines. I will delete these lines on the floor because they are confusing me a bit right now, so I will just delete them. Also, they are don't need it right now, so let's delete them too.